The three big killers of your...
Mike?
Yes?
You said three?
Yes?
You had four fingers.
No, I didn't.
You did.
No, I didn't.
I'm just saying.
I didn't.
Okay. It's okay.
I didn't.
We can do it again.
Okay.
Let's do it again.
Okay. When it comes to danger to your computer, I always watch out for what I call the big three, RFI, EMI, and ESD. To help you understand the difference between these three, I'm going to be using this hard drive as a tool. Now, let's start with the least dangerous of all, and that's RFI. RFI stands for radio frequency interference. And anybody who's ever listened to music on a radio can appreciate that sometimes you get crackles and pops. That's interference, as different levels of radio waves are interflicting with each other and causing problems. Now, my hard drive itself, when it's sitting inside a computer, there's no way that RFI can hurt it. However, if I were to take this hard drive and then plug it into a computer and put it as part of a wireless network, as I was trying to transfer data off this hard drive and say to another computer, RFI could potentially cause trouble as I'm transferring the data. Now keep in mind, wireless networks and things like that are designed to watch for RFI, and they can simply resend data. So of the three, RFI is the least dangerous. The next one is EMI, or electromagnetic interference. EMI is basically large magnetic waves in places they shouldn't be. Now this hard drive right here stores data magnetically. Literally inside this drive are platters, and there's magnetic charges that hold a charge, either positive or negative, that determine the ones or zeros that my hard drive stores. Now if I took a large magnet right now and passed it over this hard drive, I could wipe the data quite easily. In fact, it's a common process they use for wiping hard drives. They call it degaussing. Now the thing is, with EMI in most cases, it will destroy the data, but it won't destroy the drive itself. So EMI can wipe data, but we can still, in most cases, continue to use the hardware. The scary one, the one we have to watch out for, is ESD, or electrostatic discharge. ESD is that static shock you get when you touch a doorknob. Now, for you and I, it's not that big of a deal. But if you take a look on any piece of computer electronics, it's covered with delicate little circuitry, and only the most tiniest charge in the millions of volts can destroy this equipment. So electrostatic discharge is a huge problem when it comes to working on PCs. So let's take a moment and build a system up, and let me show you what we can do to prevent electrostatic discharge. The biggest thing to remember about ESD is that you don't want ESD to happen. Electrostatic discharge simply means that you have two different things that have different electrical potentials. And when they come in contact with each other, one discharges into the next. Now that's really important to appreciate. The CompTIA exams say that you should always unplug your computer before you're working on it. Now the reason they say that is because your computer has a ground plugged into the wall. So when you're working on your computer, you have the ultimate ground, the perfect ground coming from the power company. So when you're unplugged, the only thing you have to worry about is the difference between that which you're working on and you and any other parts that come around. So, number one, anytime you're working inside a computer, just make a point to touch the metal case, preferably the power supply, from time to time to keep yourself in potential. Now, if you really want to do it right, though, you can use anti-ESD equipment. What I have here is an anti-ESD mat, and I'm wearing this fancy fashion statement of an anti-ESD wristband. Let me show you how these guys work. First of all, I'm going to go ahead and snap this guy in, and I'm going to snap him anywhere onto the case. A lot of times you'll see the word power supply. I'm against the power supply primarily because you try to plug this alligator clip into the power supply and then there's a fan and you end up having funny things happen. So I like to put it onto the case itself. Now what I've done is anything that I'm pulling out of the computer is going to be at the exact same potential as this. So if, for example, I pull a card out of my computer, I can place it on the anti-ESD mat without any fear of there being a potential discharge. If I took the same card and laid it on a table or anything else, it could literally short into that particular thing. So just by having an anti-ESD mat, I eliminate that entire issue. If you really want to play it safe, what you need to do is use your anti-ESD wristband. This is keeping all my components at the same potential, but I want to keep myself at the same potential as well. So what I'm going to do is snap myself in, and this has a resistor in here. And now I, my equipment, and the computer are all at the exact same electric potential. Now you can get a lot crazier than this, and in environments where they're really worried about ESD, you can do things like have anti-static workbenches. You can actually wear special boots that prevent static electricity from when you're scuffling around. So there's, you can really take it a lot further. But what you're seeing right here is pretty standard. In general, ESD is only a big risk when it comes to CPUs and RAM. Pretty much almost anything else can take a fairly good hit. So unless I'm explicitly told by my boss I have to wear this stuff, I usually don't wear this unless I'm working with a CPU and RAM. Okay. Now, this isn't quite where ESD ends. Anytime you buy a new piece of equipment, invariably it's going to come in a box like this, and it's going to be wrapped in this wonderful stuff called an anti-static bag. CompTIA loves to talk about these things, so we will too. When you're using anti-static bags, they're great. And for example, if you want to temporarily set something down on an anti-static bag, that's fine. But when you're transporting, and this is clearly in the CompTIA objectives, you are supposed to carry it inside the anti-static bag. And that way you're absolutely guaranteed not to toss this down on a table or something and get an ESD that you weren't otherwise anticipating. I love anti-static bags. I use them like crazy. I buy these huge monsters and buy the ton, and I use them for just about everything. But I will tell you, I'm a little bit different than CompTIA when it comes to this. For me, the other thing I like to use are the anti-static foam that you'll see that comes with a lot of devices. I'm perfectly happy laying it down on a piece of anti-static foam, and if I need to carry it around, I'm going to break the CompTIA rules. You know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to carry it like this with the foam or the bag. I don't necessarily have to put it in the bag. So remember those rules when it comes to ESD, and not only will you pass the CompTIA A+, but you'll also save a lot of equipment.